Hello guys, why I recommend every man to have the experience to work as a gigolo, right? So the problem is that as a man feel more confident and valuable in relationship to women. As I had this problem, I just didn't felt valuable enough, made me feel insecure, and it kept on coming and coming. So this is a problem and it never went away. So when I did this working as a gigolo, it helped me through this another level, gave me another level with women. So I could recommend it to every man. It will make men less aggressive and knowing really on the next level how to have more influence on women and get their desired sex without having to use violence and all those stupid stuff. You know, some men go totally crazy and do stupid stuff. So if you do this for life investment. So there are negative side effects if, for me, when I haven't been doing this job. Negative side effects are, you know, what I said, I didn't feel valuable enough in a relationship to women. I was scared talking to them, especially when they're pretty. I felt really uncomfortable. I was spending too much money, in my opinion, on women. Didn't know how to make valuable experience for women with women. How, you know, like I said in a previous episode, making them feel comfy, burning candles, knowing all the tips and tricks when it comes to sex and all these dating experience, and knowing to take them in this new experience that are really relax and let go and let you take control without spending a lot of money. Because my mind was like, oh, the money will do all the work. I will just pay. I will brag. She will think. I was mainly focused on what she thought about me being successful. That was a big mistake. And this really turned me inside out, like, no, I have to create this value. And I didn't know how too much about my own hygiene style class until I did this private man thing, of course, working as a gigolo, and then eventually built my own company around it. So this is one of the companies. So that made me really more mature with women when it comes to using class, style, etiquette, things that I have noticed that most women can learn a lot from. Really, it's amazing, and they love it if you tell them, because they need good arguments, because they want to improve their lifestyle, they want to take it to a higher level. Okay, of course, what you need to know: becoming a gigolo isn't that easy. There are many thoughts about gigolos. I mean, there's many, like, in my opinion, before I did this work almost 7 years ago, I thought they were funny, like this Juice Bigelow, or they were really like strippers, or they were really nasty, you know, and all this. No, that's not what I'm talking about. Both of them not true. The type of gigolo man is class, knowledge, appearance, and is willing to give a woman the time of her life in the moment and return for the financial reward. So he is putting for rent his lifestyle, his class, his house, his, you know, his everything he has. Maybe most of the time they don't want to meet at your place, but everything that he has and he knows to make a woman have a new experience with him, the type of man, if he knows, you know, all this kind of stuff. For me, as a successful entrepreneur, the next step for me was to get to this level with women, because I was done playing around. I haven't been through picking a woman, multiple relationships, you know, been there, done that. This seemed to me like the next level. The important thing was simple, because when you get to get this deeper knowledge, it gave me more confidence, made me feel more confident. I got more feedback from these women because they paid for it. So I got more accurate feedback from this woman, and I took it to a more professional level, you know, like the hygiene, because you get paid for it. So you have to put it to the next level, like your style, your class, how you talk, what you know about wines, how you to dress, how to open doors, you know, all these rules and stuff and these massage things and everything that comes with it. So for me, it got more professional, and thus I got more discreet and also more trustworthy to women, and I was more able to separate having a great time, to separate this great time creating experience from money. I didn't have to intertwine it like I did when I was younger. I did intertwine it, like, oh, will she pay? I will do this, then she will do that. So it was really on my, I really had to arrange everything. And that changed the whole situation, because if you really have to arrange everything, you have to know everything, right? From the beginning till the end, how will she feel? You're getting this feedback, how she felt about it, if she liked it, what she didn't like about it. And that's real personal comments that you will, most of the time, women won't tell you because they don't want to make you feel bad. And this is real honest feedback, because you are just delivering a service. So it makes you real professional. And I could recommend everybody for personal growth and personality and style, everything with women. So what to do about this? Of course, there are many types of gigolo, like I said, and I'm not talking about the funny stripping type of guy. I'm talking about this timeless classic guy having a great job, career, and doing this on the side and for a period of time. So for me, the main reason that I did this was that, and I was just not playing around with women, but you know, women do want to have some certainty when it comes to a relationship, when it comes to relationships, or when you have certain dates, they want to have some security. And you know, to avoid breaking hearts and making them, you know, having to do, I didn't do promises. I was real clear about, you know, I just want to have sex. But although, you know, they're just, in their opinion, they're wasting their time, you know, I mean, from their perspective, because they just want to have a boyfriend and they hope it will be you, but in the end, you know, you are not the guy. And for me, it was a great step, because I could just have sex with women, build on my style, class, and everything I just wanted, and didn't have to hurt women, didn't break any hearts. I mean, these women who paid me were really happy that I was just for the moment and just didn't stick, that I just left. I mean, there were also women who looked great, had great boobs, had a lot of money. So you will meet somewhere, maybe someone more ugly, not really ugly. I wouldn't say women are ugly, but most of the time women are well shaved. I mean, everything, well, hygiene and everything, you know, well taken care of. With men, it will be totally different. So these women, you know, was great. And that's why I could really recommend for the experience to see the women from another perspective and learning that you can be in a woman's life and leave, that they don't, not all of them want to stick. If they have their own priorities, they have a great life, they will look somewhere else. They don't need you. They're really like also, they are really in control. Women are really in control. You are the lucky guy if you have the chance to have a great experience with a woman in a relationship, whatever. You are a lucky guy, although you have to keep in your own control. You don't want to lose your own control. So if I had a son, I would definitely make sure he experienced this for a certain time in his life, because you don't want to miss out on this. This is the greatest experience. This makes you really more confident with women, more secure, knowing what's the difference between money, value, and a woman's discretion, those kind of stuff. You know, you will learn so much things that It's things that your father will never teach you. So my opinion on this, as a final note, is that when you have the knowledge of debt relationships, like I said, like I had multiple relationships, I had left women, I had multiple dating, sexual experience, and then I really knew, like, if I go to this next level, I can implement all this information and go to the next level. So, in my opinion, I think I had to work hard for it. At a certain time, I had to do some extra readings and books, changed my closet with clothing, and, you know, had to do some interviews and then, you know, get it rolling, learning. And then finally, I got my first date after a couple of years. So it took some investment, but it gave me a lot in return, a lot of knowledge and confidence and a style, class that I can just implement. I'm just, you know, with women, and yeah, best investment. And of course, it made me some money. It makes money, but you don't want to have like the idea like you're going to be really rich. It's just, you make a good money. I mean, you have a great time, you make some money, and that's good. But I wouldn't do it for the money. I was having my own business, and that's also what I would recommend. So guys, if you like this video, please subscribe, like, share, comment. If you have any questions, ask. I'm here, you can just ask. Next week, and of course, if there's some more questions about this, I will have some more videos about this topic, gigolo. So don't worry, just keep following me. But next week, I want to talk about a more serious subject. We're going to a serious subject this time, because there's always a serious side in emotions with women. Why a man shouldn't have to feel bad if he leaves a woman. Yeah, that's quite crucial. Certainly when you are in too deep in a relationship, then this is totally not funny. So for those guys, and if you are not in a serious relationship, you should know because if this happens, you know, this is not a brick wall you can break with your fist. You're really angry. This will just tear down your whole mind. You can't think. Like, you know, you will feel like you are getting destroyed inside, crying. You know what happens when you really are feeling lost? Like you're seeking and looking for, but there's nobody left who wants to help you. You will feel like helpless. So guys, next week, why a man shouldn't feel bad when he leaves a woman. Subscribe, like, comment, add, ask questions, share, you know, build this Rise Fest Fam. I will see you in the next episode next week. And for now, have a great week. See ya.